one here. Sherrod dribbles down the lane, hop step, flips it up. A beautiful shot up and in off the glass, and the Buffs have the lead. For the Buffs, back to Jay, got a pick. Jay drives inside, off to Maya Hollingshed, and she'll lay it up and in. Frieda dribbles right to the corner. Kalinska drive inside, goes for the
layup. Welcome back to the Buffalo Stampede. Voice of the Boss, Mark Johnson. Time to talk women's basketball. J.R. Payne's team had been sitting at 2-0 and then opened up Pac-12 conference play last week. Took what might be the toughest road swing in the Pac-12 through the Oregon schools. They dropped a couple of ball games at number 10 Oregon and then number 17 Oregon State. Looking to bounce back on Tuesday night, heading down Highway 36 to take on the DU Pioneers. But they dug themselves an early hole. The Buffaloes did erase a 13-point second-half deficit inside Hamilton Gymnasium, but the comeback fell just short. The Pios held on the final seconds for an 85-84 win, snapping Colorado's five-game winning streak against the in-state rival. On a positive note, senior Maya Hollingshed recorded her third double-double of the season, finishing up with 18 points and a career-high 15 rebounds. Sophomore Jalen Sherrod led the Buffs in scoring with a career-high 22. And the continued stellar play by freshman Frieda Foreman had the best scoring night of her early career, finishing up with 17 points in the loss to the Pios. Afterward, we heard from head coach J.R. Payne.
Lob back to Blackston. She'll fire a three. Yeah!
We show in spurts what we're capable of, but that's the tough thing is you can't play in spurts. You got to play, like you said, consistently in. I actually thought we regrouped at halftime very well, you know, and I just told the team I was really proud of them for being able to dig in when things were tough and when we were down, and, you know, they rallied together. It wasn't anything I said or anything I did. It was them. They made a decision that they were going to dig in and compete. And they did that and got themselves back in the ball game. So I'm very proud of that. But I mean, yeah, they're exhausted. Every day is exhausting for every student athlete in America right now and every coach. We definitely need the rest. I mean, the travel and the, you know, two top 20 teams and then a third in 5 days is really tough, not just physically, but also emotionally. And so we need a little bit of a break. We need to rest, study up. You know, we have players that are real concerned about final exams and things like that, so we need a day or two to rest up and get ready to go again.
Head coach J.R. Payne after the Buffaloes' one-point loss to the Pios on Tuesday down in Denver. The Buffaloes are now 2-3 on the campaign. Next up now on Monday, men's and women's basketball having a day-night doubleheader. The Buffalo women will take on Utah in a Pac-12 conference match at noon at the CU Event Center. And then later on that night, the Buff men will take on the Bears of Northern Colorado at 7 o'clock. Our coverage on the Colorado Basketball Network gets underway at 6:30 with Scott Wilkie and yours truly as Tad Boyle's team tries to bounce back after that loss at Tennessee this past week. As for football this week, it's no longer a Friday night game between the Buffs and the Utes. It's a Saturday morning affair, of course. Let's hope the weather cooperates. Gary Barnett, Andy Lindahl, and I will hit the air at 8 o'clock in the morning. It's Breakfast with the Buffaloes with the Buffalo Stampede pregame show, and then the kickoff between the Buffs and the Utes at 10 o'clock a.m. at Folsom Field as the head coach of the Buffaloes, Carl Durrell and company, look to go 5-0 on the season, and we'll see what happens in terms of them potentially getting into the Pac-12 championship game, although the Buffaloes need a little help in that regard. That'll wrap up the Buffalo Stampede this week. I'm Voice of the Boss, Mark Johnson. We'll talk to you next time.